opening in 1266 to the start to make a splash in Michigan to try to get kids to learn to swim. I don't want any other family to go through what my family went through. I remember at 15, my mom was choking back tears as she was trying to explain what happened to me and filling in all the spots of when I was 5 and I was drowned. So it's so important that we travel all over the U.S. and teach more and more people the importance.
Great, great. And one of the things that Richmond Swims is best at is inclusiveness, you know, along racial lines, ethnic lines, socioeconomics. Can you talk a little bit about what that means to you to be able to support an organization that's doing that?
You know, for myself, being the first black American to have a world record, one of my friends came up to me and said, do you know what you just did? Do you know what you just did for the sport of swimming? And for me at the time, I was just so focused on trying not to mess up because it was one of the biggest races of my life. But when I got home, I started looking at family and friends that, you know, used to make fun of me, like, oh, you wear those Speedos? And now they're switching it up. The whole storyline's like, oh, wait, how's swimming going? And I started thinking about them not being safe around the water. So I fully support any program like Richmond Swims that is focused on diversifying sports swimming and getting more people to learn the importance of swimming. People of color are drowning at an exponential rate compared to other counterparts, and we need to change that. And the only way we can do that is have formal lessons. And once people start learning to swim, it's a no-brainer that they get their kids to learn to swim. So we're breaking generational barriers by teaching kids to swim.
Terrific. And lastly, tell me what you enjoy most about working with kids in settings like this.
Wow. I've had a very long career, 12 years as a pro swimmer. And I think, truly, if it wasn't for Make a Splash, I don't think I would have been able to do it for so long. And why do I say that? Because when I travel to each shortstop, every time I watch someone go underwater for the first time, conquer fear, blow bubbles for the first time, it just gave me so much hope. And then I went back and trained and tried to win gold for the USA. But I think watching people just conquer fears, learning something that I sometimes take for granted. When I swim, it's like me walking. So many of us that know how to swim take it for granted. More and more people understand how hard it is to learn to swim so that they can take it for granted and swim off.
Wonderful.